is a quick guide to tracing your own icons to make custom icons for your own home screen. Firstly, make sure you've got a copy of the app icon saved in your Photos app. When you've done this, I'm going to use Procreate, but there are loads of drawing apps you could use. In fact, you could even use the built-in apps like Keynote to do this. This tutorial is for Procreate, but I'm sure you can work out how to do it in your own application of choice. I'm going to make a new document, and I'm going to make sure it's a square canvas. In the upper right-hand corner on my new canvas, I can go onto the Layers button, and here I'm going to change my background colour. Because I'm going for my chalkboard aesthetic, I'm going to make my background a very, very dark grey, nearly a black colour. And now I'm going to import my app icon. So in Procreate, go to the left-hand side in the corner and press the little spanner, and you're going to choose to import a photo. Here I can use the shortcut at the bottom to make that app fill the entire square canvas, and because my icon is going to be a square, that's the perfect option. And when I've done this, I'm going to press my Layers button again, and I'm going to make that layer slightly transparent, about 50% opacity. This means I'll be able to see my drawing on top, no matter what colour it is. Then I'm going to press the plus button to add a new layer. For my chalkboard style, I'm going to get some charcoal. I'm just going to choose charcoal black, and I'm going to make sure the colour of my brush is white. And then, really simply and quite roughly, to be honest, I'm going to sketch around the icon shape itself. Not the actual box around the outside, just the detail of the icon. So I'll trace around my speech bubble, nice and quickly, and then I'm going to do some shading in the middle. In order to keep my chalkboard aesthetic, I'm not going to do this very neatly. As you would do on a chalkboard, to be honest, it wouldn't always be very neat. And when I'm done, I can go back to my Layers tab, and this time I can hide the layer with the app icon itself on it. That leaves me with my background and my drawing layer. From here, tap on the spanner in the top left, and you're going to export this as a JPEG and save it in your camera roll. You've now got your own custom app icon that you've drawn, ready to use in your Shortcuts app to replace the current app icon. Check out my tutorial for that at the end of this video, and good luck customising your home screen with your own icons. Hey, thanks for watching that video. Now, if you enjoyed that and you want to find some more quick tips for your iPad or to use in your classroom, do me a favour and press the subscribe button down below. That will really help me out, and it will help you keep up to date with all the latest tips and tricks on my YouTube channel.